Good evening, good morning, good afternoon, wherever you are in this vast place we call Earth. Today I'm going to talk to you about the charismatic preacher from Transformational Church, I believe it's in Oklahoma, a pastor named Mike Todd. Just when I thought it couldn't get any worse, these false teachers take it to a new high. But before I go into my commentary, I'm going to go ahead and play the video for you. And you tell me what you think. Then I'm going to come back and talk about Mike Todd and these false teachings. And six signs that you may be a part of a church that's not teaching the true gospel. You may be a part of a church that is we call apostasy. Church of the apostasy. A church that has walked away from the true gospel. So watch the video. And I'll come back with my commentary.
Changing something and you don't see it clearly yet. But you hear. And this is where most people would not face Jesus anymore. What most people would do is turn away. What I'm telling you is just as he's physically standing here, knowing what's coming, God's saying, can you physically and spiritually and emotionally be able to stand when getting the vision or receiving it might get nasty? I'm gonna say it in a point just like that. Receiving vision from God might get nasty. You mean, God, I just bought, in crazy faith, I just bought my dream car. And now you're going to ask me to sell it back and ride in the hoopty again? Yeah, because the vision I'm about to give you, it might get nasty. And do you hear and see the responses of the people? What I'm telling you is how you just reacted is how the people in your life will react when God is doing what it takes for the miracle. What are you saying? This man was blind, and what he was trying to do with this man is give him his.
Well, you saw the video. I don't even know what to say. Just when I thought it couldn't get any worse, it gets worse. Many of today's, I don't even call these guys preachers. I call them motivational speakers. They only talk about love and your best life now, and they make you as the person the center of the gospel, when the center of the gospel is Jesus Christ. If something seems wrong, look in the scripture for yourself and judge with righteousness so the truth is not blasphemed. You know, these preachers, they never cease to amaze me. The Bible tells us in 2 Timothy 3, verses 2 to 4, for men shall be lovers of themselves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, trucebreakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despiser of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. For this sort which creep into houses and led captive silly women laden with sins, led away with diverse lusts, ever learning and never coming to the knowledge of the truth. Mike Todd, he's done a lot and he said a lot of things in his past preachings, and he's got a huge following on YouTube, on Instagram. He has these reels out there, and folks want their ears tickled. We see that in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 3 through 1. Paul tells Timothy, I charge thee therefore before God and the Lord Jesus, who should judge the quick and the dead at his appearing and at his kingdom. Preach the word. The gospel itself will do what God has intended to do. It will save men's soul. God's word is more powerful than my words, more power than Mike's, Todd's words, or any preacher's word. God's word will do it all. But he tells Timothy, preach the gospel. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and doctrine. Now, this is what Paul was saying. It was back in his time, and we know what's happening today. You just saw a video of a man put spit as a prop in another man's eye. And the other guy who allowed that to happen, that's another story for another day. I'm not letting anybody put spit on my eyes. Mike Todd is not Jesus. And he used that whole scripture so far out of context. We call it a homiletics misjustice. A homiletics misjustice. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust, shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. I'm truly convinced that if you have the Holy Ghost or the Holy Spirit, he will open your eyes to these false entertainers or false teachers. So what we have to do is study, show yourself approved unto God, a workman that needed not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. That's found in 2 Timothy 2:15. It's time we come out from amongst these false teachers, these false prophets, these false apostles, and we expose them for who they are. Paul wrote this scripture in Timothy to a young pastor. He wrote it to Timothy to address the church. Paul wasn't writing the scripture to the world. He was writing to the church. So when he talks about all these negative, these adjectives about being high-minded, lovers of pleasure, fierce, despisers, false accusers, trucebreakers, not liking good, he's talking to the church. He's talking to the church. Let that set in. Many people think he's talking to the world. The world is already gone. We know that. The world has rejected Christ and they are already under condemnation. But Paul's talking to the church. Many of today's preachers, or I use preachers very lightly, or these motivational speakers or these false teachers, they only talk about love and what your best life now. All they want is your money. All they want is your money. They don't care about your soul. They know if you preach the truth, folks nowadays have itching ears. They want mega churches. They want mega donations and mega money. So I'm going to tell people what they want. Give the people what they want. You know the song, give the people what they want. Give the people what they want. So they have itching ears. So here's our six key signs that you may be attending a false church, or a church we call the apostasy church. First one. Jesus is only a disclaimer rather than a central point of the gospel. When they make the gospel about you, your happiness, your health, your wealth, your name it, claim it, grab it, blab it, when they put you in the center of the gospel or the scripture, my brother and sister, you are attending a false church. Number two, the gospel is about you rather than a cross. Jesus, the gospel is about Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection. Number three, money equals faith and prosperity. So folks who don't have a lot of money, they're going to question your faith. And they're going to make you continue to think you have to give and give and sow seeds until you get what God has for you. The devil is a lie. Sin, number four, sin and repentance is hardly ever taught. Number five, when was the last sermon you heard your pastor talk about justification, sanctification, and glorification? About this salvation, about working this out through your justification, salvation, your glorification. When was the last time your pastor preached about that? The cross of Calvary. And last, number six, when you have blatant sin in leadership that's perverse, when pastors are constantly falling because they're out there doing everything they're big and bad enough to do, and God opens and exposes them, And some church folks still stay in those churches. Now I want to say,
I'm with you.
What else God do to open your eyes to let you know, hey, church? Satan has his own ministers too. The Bible says he has angels. He's the angel of light, and he has his own ministers. And oftentimes these motivational speakers, I used to say many, but this time I say most of these motivational speakers are tools of the devil. So what Mike Todd did was a new low. How low can you go? How low can you go? Say that you had to do that to get a following. All we have to do is preach the word. God has given us 66 books, 39 Old Testament, 27 New Testament, written over 1,000 years. That's still relevant today. All you have to do is read his word. Ask him for his Holy Spirit. He will open your eyes. And you will too, like I did back in the day when I was a new Christian. He began to open my eyes. Hey, this person is not teaching, right? And as you study the word and you have the Holy Spirit guiding you and teaching you, you'll begin to quickly see false teachers, false prophets, false apostles, whatever they may call themselves. They're nothing but tools of the enemy. So Mike Todd, shame on you. Shame on you. Well, this is Damon from Life Inspiration. If you like this video, I encourage you to like, share, and subscribe. And I have plenty of other videos all about life, and I like to have fun. But most of all, I want to tell you about a man who can save your soul. And his name is Jesus Christ. So until next time, this is Damon from Life Inspiration. Make sure you like, subscribe, share, and send this video to other folks who need to hear the truth about some of these false teachers. Mike Todd, shame on you.